environmental issues, and also our research findings in KIS. At first, I briefly introduced the pollution issues related to marine debris, because the marine debris is closely to the microplastic pollution. By virtue of cheap price, high buoyancy, and plastic production has steeply increased from 1950. So their annual increase rate is about 8%. And world production in 2012 is 280 million tons. If this trend continues, accumulated production will be 33 billion tons by 2050. Many years, a lot of the plastic waste is generated. It is estimated about 275 million metric tons of plastic waste is generated in 2010. Among them, 8 million metric tons of plastics entered the ocean each year. Large production, large consumption of the plastics lead to accumulation of plastic waste in natural habitat that resulting in the adverse effect on marine wildlife and marine environment. The marine debris can injure and kill the marine wildlife, mainly through entanglement and ingestion. They can also destroy the habitats of wildlife. And also, marine debris have a significant impact on the social economies. Governments will waste a lot of money for cleaning the beaches and the coasts of marine debris. And also, the marine debris caused the reduction of income as a result of the reduction of the tourists. If people's hesitate to visit the coasts by presence of the marine debris. And also, the ghost fishing by direct fishing gear can cause the loss of the potential valuable food for human consumption. Marine debris also present the danger to navigation. Which has been related to many accidents. Some of them caused many mortalities. According to a recent report from the Convention on Biological Diversity, 373 species have been impacted, among which 50% on the IUCN red list. The increasing rate is about 40% in the last review compared to the last review in 1997. According to this report, 100% of turtles impacted from the entanglement, and also seabird also affected about 30% from the entanglement and ingestion. Actually, the marine debris issue has a long history, but recently, microplastic, people recognize microplastics, that is mainly the fragments from the marine debris. According to their origin, the marine debris can be, the microplastic has two different types. We can separate two different types. One is primary microplastics. Primary microplastics are mainly the plastics manufactured intentionally for the certain purpose. That includes the plastic resin pellet and micro beads in personal products. Plastic pellet, resin pellet is raw material of the plastics, plastic product that is remelted and remolded to produce the end-use product. The cosmetics, in cosmetics, huge amount of micro beads are included as a separating agent. Secondary microplastic is produced by weathering and fragmentation of large size marine debris, plastic debris. They are commonly found on beaches and sea surface and sea zoologies and marine animals. Actually, marine marine microplastic have changed paradigm of marine debris at the aspect of fate and effect of marine debris. The marine debris entering the ocean become smaller from mega size to meso, micro, nano size. As the size becomes smaller, the potential of entanglement will be reducing. However, the target species, target organism that can ingest microplastic is steeply increased. That means the bioavailability and the toxicity will be increased. The huge of the large of the animal can be exposed to microplastic from large species such as marine mammal and seabird to the marine invertebrate and juvenile swims. And also detection on and cleaner will be difficult. Over the 10 years, a lot of reports has been published on microplastics. The reports presented ubiquitous distribution of the microplastics from coast to Arctic, temporary increasing trend, and ingestion by various kinds of animals, and potential toxicity of microplastics. And also, there's a role as a transporting media of pollutant. These kinds of the evidence raising some concern on microplastic. In fact, now it becomes clear microplastic is very common in the marine environment and marine species. However, their trend, toxic potential, and roles for the transporting media of pollutant and nanoplastic production still. We have a question on this, and the scientists are conducting actively research on this field until now. So, international society began to pay attention on microplastics from 2010. For example, IOC selected microplastics one of the emerging issues in high level of 23 ocean health. In 2014 and 2016, this year, United Nations Environment Assembly, UNEA, designated some resolutions on marine plastic debris and microplastics. The resolution requests the executive director to review about the microplastic pollutions and also make some effective strategic and approaches to combat marine plastic debris and microplastics. So, the overall question, the main question from the international body is whether marine debris is a serious problem or just red marine. This main question. But to answer to this question, there are a lot of the language gaps. As I already mentioned, microplastic is globally distributed. In the environment, many metrics, many places, microplastics can be detected. So, the publication on this is steeply increasing. So, microplastic also found in terrestrial and freshwater environment as well, and also indoor and outdoor air. And also, we can find the food products, diesel, beer, and honey. In this slide, I compare the levels of the abundance of microplastic in sea surface in Korea with other countries. The abundance of microplastics in Korean coast is relatively higher than European country, but lower than the USA and ocean gyres. However, the abundance of microplastic on beaches is the highest in on beaches of Korean coasts. This is closely related to the aquaculture weed. Most of the large composition aquaculture, the fragments of aquaculture weed comprise the main dominant contributors of the microplastic, the size range of 1 to 5 millimeters. I will detailly with about this, his topics later. So, the particle size of the microplastic is simply increasing with the decreasing size of microplastics. Through the laboratory and the field experiment, we found that just UV radiation can produce micro-sized EPS particles from EPS buoys. There are long-term monitoring studies was conducted in Netherlands by Dr. Kleriker. She presented that the trend of the size of the microplastic plastic debris inside the stomach. As you can see, the size is gradually increased. There is a decreasing trend, high trend. This slide shows the microplastics we detected from the Korean samples from the oyster and mussel. The overall level, still the data is limited. This study just conducted in Jinhae and Goje area, in the southern part of Korea. So the level is higher than European country, but lower than Chinese up to now. There are a variety of types of the microplastics, including alkyd, teflon, polyethylene, nylon, polypropylene, this is styrofoam, polyester, and acrylic. Another hot issue of microplastic is the seafood contamination with microplastic. The international body and many government and people wanted to know there's a risk for the human. But still, to answer this question, there are a lot of the questions than the evidence. So recently, there are some papers that was published on the contamination of microplastics in seafood collected from the market. This report comes from the USA. They analyzed the samples from Indonesia and USA. And this is from China. That nowadays, it is clear seafood can contain those type of microplastics. Because marine is contaminated, and there's inhabitant also contaminated either. So that is reasonable. So there's an increase in the reports on the toxicological effect of microplastics. I summarized the overall effects on this slide. The microplastic exposure leads to the inhibition of photosynthesis and decreased feeding activity, low fecundity, weight loss, and decreased energy reserve, and depressed immune response, and so on. But most of the study was, most of this experiment conducted under controlled laboratory condition with very high concentration of microplastics. So, to apply those toxicological data to the risk assessment of microplastic in the real environment, we need to the information about the toxicological potential of microplastic reflecting the environmental condition, such as the shape, size, and polymer type, and so on. So this year, a paper was published in Science. They exposed the microplastics with the environmental relevant level and found the changed behaviors and stunted growth of the larval tissues. One of the issues of the microplastic is the toxic chemicals inside microplastics. Plastic can contain two types of the chemicals. One chemical is comes from the outside. Due to the hydrophobic surface of the plastic, they can actively concentrate the organic contaminant in surrounding waters. So they can concentrate up to the 100,000 times higher than those in water. And also the other chemical is additive chemicals. Additive chemical is intentionally added during the plastic production to enhance certain purpose. Usually, additive chemical contained at a high concentration. So, if they use or enter the ocean, they can easily out of the plastics to the water column. Then they can be a source of the contaminant in the environment. The main question on this issue is, can marine debris and microplastic be a moving source or vector of hazardous chemicals in the marine environment? There are debates on the potential of microplastics as a vector of chemicals to marine organisms. One scientist group insisted on facilitating the leaching of chemicals from plastic particles in digestive organs of marine biota and induce adverse health effects. The other group insists that the role of plastic in bioformation of hazardous chemicals is negligible and even reduce the uptake of such chemicals. The debate is ongoing. So from now, I will introduce chemical pollutions in Korea and our effort to improve government policy on this issue. This slide shows the top 10 marine debris items from the world and South Korea during the international cleanup activities for 10 years. As you can see, plastic is a major item of marine debris. Interestingly, in Korean list, we can see the two different types of the marine debris, that is the V and low. V is mainly the styrofoam V. Low is mainly the fishing rod. That means this data is well reflected the high development of fisheries, fishing industries in South Korea. So, as you can see, the styrofoam debris is a top predominant item in both macro size and micro size debris in Korea. That comes from the aquaculture activity, mainly comes from the aquaculture activity. Along the western and the southern coast of Korea, aquaculture is very active. So after the heavy rain and the storm, huge amount of styrofoam is stranded along the beaches. That is after that, they fragmented and degraded, made for small size microplastics. Accidentally, we found the styrofoam contains one kind of the toxic chemicals. It's one of the fluorinated flame retardants. Actually, that is hexabromo cyclodecane. This is additive type of fluorinated flame retardant, and they are mainly used for the styrofoam insulation blocks for construction. But unexpectedly, they are included in styrofoam waves. Due to their persistency, long range transportability, bioaccumulativity, and toxic properties, they are designated as a persistent organic pollutant for the global elimination of the Stockholm Convention. We found those chemicals are enriched in bottom sediment nearby the aquaculture areas. That is the strong field evidence. The plastics on sea surface can affect marine environment. They can be a source of the marine environment. Next step, we try to verify the chemicals can transport to marine species. Because in the environment, there are a lot of the contaminant sources placed together, it is very hard to discriminate those. So we look at the inhabiting species. So the mussels inhabiting on the styrofoam weed showing the high concentration of HMCD, and there's the isomeric profile also reflected on their substrate. And also we detect the styrofoam particles inside the mussel. So actually, in fact, the Korean government has recognized these problems for a long time, from the maybe since 2008, but they thought the benefits, price, easy to handle, VOC, and resistance of the industry, they thought these benefits are more important than the environmental impact. But we input the scientific data and then try to change the government policies now. So government changed the policy now. They decided to replace the start of green and they increase the recovery rate and they regulated the HVCD use in start of green from 2017 and development of alternative greens. This is a very valuable experience for us because the scientific research, scientific data can change the government policy and can contribute to improve the environmental quality. Thank you very much.
Are there any questions or comments?
So again, yeah, when we are talking about the plastic debris, now it's becoming a trending issue in the world, especially now in Indonesia. As information for you, that now the biggest number two after China producer plastic waste. Yeah.
After China. Generation,
yeah. Yeah. Indonesia now becoming the biggest number two producer of waste of the plastic after China. Number one is China, number two is Indonesia. So last month, I think we have done a coordination internally in the government, and then now many policy has been implemented in the society, such as, you know, when we are going to buy something from a super mall, normally we will get plastic for free, but now we have to pay. Yeah. And the second one of the governor close to Jakarta, they have already issued regulation. They now prohibit to use styrofoam. So now, I mean, to promote not using plastic. This, I think, is quite important thing. But the problem is, this is not only country to country, but should be integratedly, yeah, regional or even international. If we just do partially, I do believe the successful will not come through. Thank you.
International cooperation is very important because marine debris is moving around the current ocean current. So some coordination for the combat the marine debris is very important.
Any other? Yes.
In the data you showed that particle size is getting smaller over time in the plastic debris. Is this, what is the ultimate cause of this? Are there several causes? Why are the particles getting smaller?
Because you mean why the small size is high?
Particle size, yeah, plastic.
Because if one particle is a fragment, large number of small particles can be produced.
Okay, that I understand. So fragmentation is the process. So that, does that mean then that we're just accumulating more and more plastic in the ocean, and through fragmentation we're seeing smaller particles over time? So this must mean that the plastic persists in the ocean for a very long period of time through the fragmentation.
Yes.